They're here?
Uh-huh.
Good. Cause they on my ride back home. It's good to see you this evening. It's good to be here. And I am so happy to have been chosen to be on the mic side of this election. Good to see my good friend, Brother Stewart.
Oh, yeah. Good
to see you. We go way back. I don't know how to, don't tell them, but I thought we could. We go way back. We have met up on various lectureships across the country. And we're still doing the same thing. So, this evening I am as peacock proud and hyena happy to be here this evening. He didn't announce my subject, but Brother Harvard, that is Robert, gave me, they say, but what does God say? They say, and it comes from the 16th chapter of the book of Matthew. The Bible says when Jesus came to the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked the disciples, saying, whom the men say that I, the Son of Man, am. Some said that he was Jeremiah, Isaiah, one of the prophets, but John the Baptist, one of the prophets. That's what they said. But Jesus asked his apostles, to whom did he say that I, the Son of Man, am. Peter said that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus told him, he said, flesh and blood did not reveal this unto thee, but my Father. See, they said that he was just one of the prophets, but God said, he was the Son of God.
Amen. Amen.
I want to start this evening by saying, church, we have a problem.
Oh, yeah.
We have a big problem.
Amen.
Because in the church of Christ, there are change agents. By that I mean that they are trying to change God's will and God's way.
All right.
But somebody forgot to tell the change agents that God said, don't add to my word.
Come on now.
Deuteronomy 4, 2.
All right. All right.
He also said in Proverbs 30,
yes, sir.
Is that right, Sean?
Yes, sir.
That's it.
Don't ask for it.
That's it.
Don't take it from me.
All right.
But if that's not enough, man, God said in the book of Revelation, chapter 22, verses 18 and 19, don't ask and don't take from me. Because he said, the plagues that are written in this book, what do we add unto you?
Yeah.
You see, God don't play.
Amen.
With his word.
Right.
These change agents, that's what they say. These change agents need to stop trying to change God's will and God's way.
Amen.
Because the book said, for we were all standing before the judgment seat. Give an account of the deeds that we have done living in the Bible.
That's right.
Not only that, but I read somewhere in the Bible it says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter.
All right.
Fear God and keep his commandments.
Yes.
For this is the duty of man.
That's it.
For God shall bring every work into the judgment, whether it's good or bad. And then I also heard Bible when it says we all want to stand before the judgment seat of Christ.
That's it.
Give an account of the deeds that we have done while living in the body.
Yeah.
And these change agents, they're trying. Can I preach that? I want you to
preach it.
They're trying to change God's will, and they want to put mechanical instrumental music in the worship service. Now, I heard somebody when they said in Romans chapter 14 and verse 13, whosoever is not of faith, yes, sir, is sin. And since it's not of faith, the Bible says it's sin.
That's right.
How does one get sin? Romans 10:17, the book says, faith coming by hearing and hearing by the, how do we get faith? Well, faith coming by hearing and hearing by the word of God. And then the Bible prayer speaks over there in Hebrews 11:6, for it is there also that if you don't have this faith, you cannot please God.
Amen.
I understand this evening that a lot of folk today who are displeasing, they call themselves churches of Christ. Not only are they calling themselves churches of Christ, but they are preachers. Let me tell you something, church preachers can make a mistake just like anybody else. We are human. And we do make mistakes. See, but it's not so bad to make a mistake, but it's real bad if you don't try to correct that mistake. When you step out on the outside of the law of faith, you need to find your way out and step back in. Since God has commanded us to sing, Ephesians 5:19, they're trying to tell me that the other day I heard a preacher say that it didn't say not to use mechanical instruments of music. I know it didn't say that, but it did say what it did say. And it said that we are saying, make melody in our hearts. Now, Brother Stewart, how can you make melody? Well, how many ways are there to make melody? I heard somebody say there weren't but two ways to make melody. And one was the mechanical instruments of music. And the other is with the vocal cord. Well, now which one does God want? I stopped by to tell you on my way home this evening, God wants the spiritual song. Singing with melody in our hearts. I don't care how long you clunk on that piano, it's not going to say a word, but long, long, long. But when you talk to God, you talk to Him according to His will. You see, we need to understand. Let me tell you something. I said this, Brother Harvin, I think you would agree with this.
All right.
And Brother Shaw, these are some dynamic preachers in the Word of God, and I respect them. The other preachers also.
Yes.
But I know them well. I think you will agree with me that we have allowed this stuff to go on.
Yeah.
As ministers of the Church of Christ too long.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the brothers said, withdraw from every brother. And what was this order? So that folks, we are to withdraw from those brothers. He said, well, that's my good friend. Withdraw from him. Well, that's my brother. Withdraw from him. That's my daddy. Withdraw from every brother. The walk is not right in the sight of God. We let it be known that we stand for God and stand for God only. Because of the fact if we don't, we're going to have to stand before God and give an account of the things that we should have done and the things that we didn't do. We're going to give an account for that. We need to stand before God only. We have, but not only that, they're trying to change the worship service. I heard somebody said they even mentioned that about changing the communion from a Sunday to a Saturday night. We are going to have to do something because of the fact that we've got some change agents in the Lord's church. And when I say the Lord's church, they might be in the church only as members, but the word is, their name is not in heaven on the Lamb's Book of Life. We need to understand we got but out of shadow beyond a shadow of God. We need to stand for God. When we stand for God, we understand it, we're standing for righteousness. And when we stand for righteousness, we need to be sure that we're standing on the side of God. I remember when over there, I believe it is Sean, we have to hit me here, but until I call for you, just hold tight. And over there, I believe, and I think the book is called Joshua, and about the 24th chapter. And Joshua 24, and I believe about verse number 14. But Joshua told the people, am I right? All right, Joshua told the people, said, now, if Baal be God, you need to serve him before me and my God. We are going to serve the Lord. I would be so glad when we find folk today. Not only that, but you know, let me say this. And I said, I preached in California, and I said the same thing. I preached in Dallas, Texas, I said the same thing. I preached in Phoenix, Arizona, I said the same thing. And over here in Tucson, Arizona, when I go there in February, I'm going to preach the same thing. I preach everywhere I go, I preach God's holy and eternal word, because every word that I speak is on my record in heaven. I'm going to tell you just like that, we who are members of the body of Christ need to hold on to study to the word of God, because one day that word is going to meet us again before when we stand before God. So therefore we all must, I don't want to sound redundantly, but the Bible says, for we must all stand before the judgment seat of Christ and give an account of the deeds that have been done while living in the old body. You can float around if you want to, but really after a while you've got to come to a standstill. When we come to a standstill, we must be sure that we're going to stand before God. When we do it, we're going to stand according to his will. He's going to judge us according to his will. You might hear him say, depart from me, you work for iniquity. I never knew you. As I said this morning in the church where I am, it's a bad situation to be in the church of Christ and go to hell from the church of Christ. You can go to hell in the way you want to, but don't go to hell from the church of Christ. I understand what is right and wrong. So therefore, we need to be sure, am I right about it? So therefore, there's another thing that the people are kind of hung up about, and that is that they're hiding Brother Shaw, behind the word of autonomy. Yeah, they're hiding behind the word of autonomy. I looked it up to be sure that it was right. The word of autonomy means self-governed. And I understand what congregation belongs to God and what one belongs to the devil. And so therefore the book said that, brother, that you want to know where I found it? I found it in the thesaurus. Thesaurus, is that right? The thesaurus said autonomy is self-governed. So if it's self-governed, that means it has no other attachment unto it. It's self-governed by itself, only itself, and nothing else. Now, if it's not by itself, then God has nothing to do with it. I might not be popular, but I don't care. I'm 91 years old, and I'm not trying to be popular. I'm just trying to tell you that it is. Don't have for a time. I know it. Some of these boys, and I'm not fighting education, but a lot of these boys who have gone to school and got an education, they come out all right. They teach it just like it is. But you find some other fellas who have gone to college and come out and teach it something else. Brother Stewart, are you fighting education? No, I'm not fighting education. Because you see, I have my degree. I have my BA degree. You see, I've been born again. MS degree. I'm in the master's service. Not only in the master's service, but I have my PhD degree. That means I preach heaven's doctrine. We got to preach God's will before we do anything else. We must need to be sure that we're in the right place, doing the right thing at the right time. Therefore, we must understand that God is not pleased with anybody that messes up his will, because he's going to call us into reward, call us into the judgment, one of these old days. And when he does, we better be sure to stand right with God. And the book tells me that we need to make our calling and election sure. We need to be sure about this thing. I hear some people say, what are you saved? They say, well, now I hope to be saved. You need to be saved right now. And that church together, when you went down in a bodily grave of baptism and you heard the word and you believed the word and you were baptized for the reason God knows sin, you came up at that point, you were saved, and you need to continue to be saved in Christ Jesus. How is that done? I can do it by doing God's will. Because God is going to bring everything into the church, whether it be good or bad.
Right.
And he changed agents that we have in the church. So, well, Brother Stewart, do we have him here in Houston? I'm afraid that we do, but have some changed agents here in Houston. And I don't care if you like it or not. I said, I'm not trying to win a popularity contest. I need to tell it just like it is. If you can like me if you want to, or you can dislike me, I don't have that problem. I love everybody, but I'm going to tell you just like it is, because when I stand before God, I've got to give an account of the deed of the thing, the word I've spoken while living in this old body. So therefore, when we come in, how much time do I have, son? When we come in to the word, that 10, Lord have mercy, that's a long time. That's a whole lot of notice, sir. And I can see a whole lot of notice. But let me tell you something else. Here's the last one of us. Our names are somewhere written, either in the book of life or in the books. I don't know where your name is, but you need to be sure that it's written on the Lamb's book of life. If it's not written on the Lamb's book of life, you're in a lot of trouble. One of these old days when Christ decided to crack the blue east and come back down here towards this earth, he's going to hover somewhere up there in the air, and he's going to call all the dead in Christ Jesus. The Bible said, and call the dead. The dead in Christ Jesus shall rise first. If you rise first, I know you'll be with Christ Jesus. So I want to be in the first resurrection. If I'm not in the first resurrection, I have an eternity worth of trouble. Well, I don't know. I told the church this morning, I say, if God can make a bush and set it afire and it don't burn up, he can keep your body and let it burn forever and never burn up. So that's what we need to be sure. We need to make our calling and election sure when we stand before the Jesus. Before Christ, the God, somebody said, I thought God was going to judge it. But the Bible said that God judges no man, but has committed all judgment unto the Son. Inasmuch as Jesus is going to judge it. Why? Because he died for us. I don't understand why people don't realize the fact that Jesus died for your sins as well as my sins. He died and we might have a right to the tree of life. Not only that, he turned up God's hill with the cross on his back and he couldn't make it. So therefore, he commanded old Simon to hit the carry the cross on the upper hill. He did it for you and for me. Held him down on the cross, suspended between two worlds. And as he did, he said, Father, I commend my spirit into thy hand. For which means Jesus said, no man taketh my life from me. I lay it down that I might take it up again. Jesus said that, am I right about it? And he's coming back one of these days, and he's going to take us up to heaven. When he called the dead in Christ, they all should get up. That's a great getting up morning. I don't want you to understand, if you can pray with a fathom in your mind, all of the Christians across the vast universe get all of the soul rising up to meet Jesus in the air. When we rise up to meet him in the air, we're going to be with him forever and forever. I want to be there because without him, I know I have a lot of problems. These changed agents need to straighten up or get straightened out one way or the other. It's up to them to make sure that they make that calling and election sure. Because if you don't, yours will not be yours to enjoy. Not only that, but you see, they're trying to change the Lord's Supper, as I said previously. Not only trying to change the Lord's Supper, trying to change singing, trying to change the church, and trying to make the church into a denominational church. And he's not going to be able to do it. God, Jesus said, when I come back, I'm coming back for the church. I'm going to deliver it up to God. Am I right about it? I'm going to deliver the church up to God. And when he does that, the book said he himself will become subject unto the Father. But now before that happens, we are down here upon this earth, and we need to make sure that we tread God from order and right way, because One of these days we're going to have to give an account. Is that right? And God called us from labor to reward. I want to be able to hear him come, be blessed of my Father, and receive a crown that's been laid for you from the foundation of the world. You've been faithful over a few things, and you are with your ruler over many. I like what Paul said. When Paul said, I have fought a good fight, I have finished my course, and I've kept the faith. And he said, I laid up for me a crown of righteousness, not to me only, but the righteous judge shall give in that day. And that great getting up morning, I want to be that. I want to be in the first resurrection to get right with the Lord. You got to do his will down here. If you don't do it down here, if you don't do it down here, it'll be too late when you travel over on the other side. You remember the time over there, I believe it was, when the rich man died. There was another fellow by the name of Lazarus. The Bible said God dispatched an angel to pick up Lazarus' soul and took it over up to where Abraham was. But as the rich man died, and the Bible said he said, he opened his eyes in hell. What did he say? He said, now, I am tormented in these flames. You see, you can't mess with the Lord and get by with it. He said, I am tormented in these flames. Not only am I tormented in these flames, he said, but I have one. Well, I would need to either have him come down and tip his finger and cool my tongue. But Abraham said, can't do that because there's a great gulf fixture. You know, it's a sad situation when you will be in heaven and you see your husband down here in another place. When the husband's up here and the wife is down here, when the husband and wife up there and the children down here, I'm talking about hell. Now I'm not talking about downtown Houston here. I'm talking about hell. Because he said, I am tormented in these flames. He said, if I have five brethren, if they don't repent, they're coming out here where I am. So therefore we must be sure that we sure that we're doing the right thing. Because the Bible says, whatsoever is not of faith, Romans 14, whatsoever is not of faith is sin. So therefore, ladies and gentlemen, as I come to a close, we need to make our covenant and let you sure. We need to be sure that we're right with God. Because if we don't, heaven will not be ours to live. We need to be sure.
Amen.
So that one of those pieces, I forgot which one it would be, said, make your covenant and elect him sure.
Amen.
We need to make our covenant and elect him sure.
Amen.
And we're sure about this thing. Mm-hmm. See, I'm not worried if God calls me today or tomorrow. I'm not worried. Because I've done what he told me.
Yeah. Amen.
And you know, and I'm saying this in come real close. When I first started preaching, I told God if he would make me a preacher, I would preach his word. And I'm going to do it along with the King.
Yeah.
And I think I'm doing a fairly decent thing. Fairly decent thing. Doing God's will. That should be the criteria of every gospel preacher.
Yes, sir.
Do God's will.
Amen.
Doing God's will. You know, he said, well done, now, good and faithful servant.
Yes,
so you've been faithful over a few things. I will make you rule over me.
Yes.
Come on up. Come on. And I know the book of Revelation is in simple understanding. But I want to walk down the streets of gold.
Come on now. Come on.
I want to look at the walls of the
gospel.
And I want the city that has 12 foundations. I want to see that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I want to walk that way.
Yeah.
Not walking on it. You got some good carpet here, but it's not like the one you got in heaven.
Come on now.
Heaven is a prepared place for a prepared people.
Amen.
Let us all get ready to go there. Let us prepare ourselves for a prepared people.
Amen.